Poetry Live, a platform to sharing your thoughts.
नमस्कार, मैं रवि कामरा, सिटी लाइव डायलॉग्स की तरफ से आज योग दिवस की पूर्व संध्या पर आपसे कुछ बातें योग की शेयर करने जा रहा हूं। हमारे साथ आज जुड़ेंगे सत्य प्रकाश जी खोसला दिल्ली से, जो 80 साल के युवा हैं और एस्कॉर्ट्स में इंजीनियर थे, लेकिन अब उन्होंने योग को अपना जीवन समर्पित कर रखा है। ये कितनी विडंबना है कि योग हर जीवन योगमय होना चाहिए। आज कोई योग को करता है तो हम कहते हैं उसने योग को समर्पित कर रखा है। वास्तव में तो योग सबके लिए है, सब उम्र के लिए है। कोई जमाना था ये सोचा जाता था कि योग केवल कुछ योगियों, खास किस्म के योगियों के लिए होता है, जो हिमालय के कंदराओं में रह के योग करते हैं या कुछ आश्रम में रह के योग करते हैं। लेकिन योग जरूरी नहीं कि केवल यंग एज के लोग करें या किसी खास वर्ग के लोग करें। योग हर एक के लिए जरूरी है। इसलिए खोसला साहब हमारे साथ आज बताएंगे आपको कि योग के साथ जीवन किस तरह से सुंदर हो जाता है। हम अपने जीवन में कुछ भी करते हैं तो किस चीज के लिए करते हैं? आनंद पाने के लिए। अगर किसी चीज में हमें आनंद नहीं आता तो हम उसे करना नहीं चाहते। लेकिन जीवन तो जीना है, तो जीवन का आनंद कैसे आए? स्वस्थ रहकर। तो इस शरीर की मेंटेनेंस, इस शरीर का रखरखाव, इस शरीर का स्वास्थ्य उतना ही जरूरी है जितना हमें अपने घर को सजाने में अपना समय, अपना पैसा लगाते हैं। और खूबसूरती की बात क्या है योग में, कि शरीर को स्वस्थ करने के लिए योग में कोई पैसा खर्च करने की जरूरत नहीं है। केवल आपके मन के संकल्प की जरूरत है कि मुझे योग द्वारा स्वस्थ रहना है। कितनी देर योग करना है, कैसे करना है, खोसला साहब बताएंगे। लेकिन अपने कुछ देर इस बात पे गर्व महसूस करते हैं कि हम उस देश के वासी हैं, ऑफ कोर्स जहां गंगा बहती है, लेकिन यहां से योग की गंगा बही पहली बार। तो भारत वो देश है जिसने सारी दुनिया को प्रेरित किया और आज 200 देश कल 21 जून को विश्व योग दिवस मनाएंगे। ये 7वां विश्व योग दिवस है, भारत की बहुत बड़ी जीत है और हमारे आदरणीय प्रधानमंत्री जी मोदी जी की बहुत बड़ी जीत है। हम स्वामी रामदेव जी से बड़े हैं। स्वामी रामदेव जी ने रोग योग का सरलीकरण किया और योग को घर घर तक पहुंचाया। इसके लिए हम उन्हें बड़े आभारी हैं उनके, और आज के दिन विशेष प्रणाम प्रेषित करते हैं उन्हें योग दिवस की पूर्व संध्या पर। तो आइए आगे बढ़ते हैं, थोड़ी सी बात करते हैं सत्य प्रकाश खोसला जी से।
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई थैंक ऑलमाइटी गॉड फॉर गिविंग मी दिस वंडरफुल अपॉर्चुनिटी टू वेलकम यू ऑल एंड स्पेशली द चिल्ड्रन फॉर दिस इंटरनेशनल योगा डे। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी प्रे टू गॉड, fold your hands, close your eyes, we pray to God for prosperity and good health. Chant Om 3 times. Start. Om. Rest, relax. Second time. Third time. Oh. hands, palms, kiss your palm, kiss the nails and pricks, rub the hands, praying to God. Oh God, give me healthy energy, positive energy for strong mind and healthy mind. Again, rub the hands for strong energy, healthy energy, divine energy, healthy heart, strong heart. No asthma, no oxygen problem. Again, rub the hands for divine energy, healthy belly, no fat. Again, rub the hands for divine energy, healthy back, no back pain. Aapka back healthy hai, to aap healthy hai. Spine, jo hai, that is the pillar of your body. Spine is healthy, you are healthy. Again, rub the hands on the knees, strong knees, healthy knees. Now we start. Mostly people think that yoga is an exercise. Actually, it is not only an exercise, it is much beyond that. And many also think that yoga is not for children, yoga is not for old people, yoga is not for sick people. It's not like this. Everybody has to do yoga. Whether he is a child or he is adult or he is old or he is on the sick bed. Even a person on the sick bed can also do yoga. Yoga means he has to move, the sick man has to move his body as per his requirement, as per his ability. If his left hand is fractured, he has to move his right hand. Otherwise, right hand will be a problem. On the bed also, he can move the right hand this way, this way, this way, this way. He has to move it. Similarly, other body parts, even on the bed, you have to move. Movement is life. Movement is yoga also. Next, our saints, sadhu, rishi, mahatma have devised and developed this yoga from the nature. They had no books, no internet, and they all picked up from the nature, perfectly. They saw the mountain like this and they made the name it as a mountain pose. They saw a lion, lion's action, they made the lion asana, lion pose. On the basis of horse, horse pose. On the basis of cat, cat pose. Similarly, all animals, the way they act, they picked up that body language and name the asana on that also. And it is very simple and very effective. And similarly, the asana is also for that boat asana. The shape of the boat also is named as a boat, boat asana, boat pose. So similarly, we have the mayur asana. As per the bird mayur, a peacock. So like that, most of the asanas are based on that. Even the tarasana, the tree, the long tree, tall tree, as per that, it is named as the tarasana. So they are very simple and easy to follow. And through that, they have devised to heal our chakras. We have 7 chakras. They are healed by yoga. And this is called holistic healing. When we go through this holistic healing, we have no disease and no problem. That is the main crux of this. And for the last, in the past 20 years, the yoga was not prevalent in the world. But currently, we must thank our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji and Baba Ramdev that he spread it all over the world like a wildfire. Everybody is following yoga. Even today, doctors are also prescribing to the patients, do some yoga, do some exercise for fast healing. So we must thank both Baba Ramdev and Narendra Modi. And doing this is very important and has to be done on a regular basis. And in the present scenario, it has become more important due to this coronavirus. It has created a lot of disease, a lot of problem, financial also, physical also, mental also. With the youngs also, they are without job, they are working on half job. The children are locked in the room. They have no fresh air. They are not exposed to the sunlight. They have no ground to play. So this all, they have no sunlight. This all leads to depression. This leads to anxiety, anger. They become hyper. And a lot of problems of mental disease and memory problem, eye problem, sugar, blood pressure, breathing problem, asthma have already developed due to this. So this can be tackled very easily by yoga at home only. So later on we will tell you how the children can do it, how the middle age can do it, and how the old and sick people can do and win over this COVID. And we will definitely win over COVID. We must thank our doctors and scientists. They have developed good medicine also to control it, but still it has not gone. We have to still maintain the discipline and distance as required to completely win over it. Next, we come to the benefits of yoga. The benefits of yoga are so many. These 10 fingers are not sufficient to count them. First of all, you will get healthy body. You will get healthy mind. Your body will be flexible. Your mind will be strong. Your memory will be sharp. Whatever disease you have will go away if you do yoga dedicatedly every day. And no disease will enter your body in future. This is a preventive yoga. There is no medicine in the world to prevent you from falling sick. That you don't have headache, you don't have stomach pain, you take this medicine, it will happen. No. But in yoga, if you do regularly, it gives you preventive system and you will not fall sick. It is a tested and tried scientific method. And next is that your connection with the God, your connection with the God through meditation, your connection with the cosmos, with the nature will be also there. And doing yoga regularly, dedicatedly, you will realize that you are getting energy from the cosmos, the mother nature. And then there are so many viruses. They have been coming for the last so many years. Sometimes mad cow, sometimes bird flu, sometimes hen flu, they are coming. And many more will come in the coming years. But a person who is doing yoga regularly, that will not disturb him. This is the wonderful thing, that doing yoga, no virus of the world will disturb you. Your immune system will be very strong. Your hypertension will go away. Your sleep disorder will go away. You get yog nidra. So there are multiple benefits. You cannot count them all. And next is some rules for yoga. How to do, when to do, when not to do, what to eat, what not to eat, like that. Most of them are already given in the magazines, publications, newspaper, different channels. You know most of them, but still I repeat some of them for your reference. Number one, yoga has to be done empty stomach. 2-3 hours gap should be there when do you yoga. Next comes the posture. Which posture you should adopt for doing the yoga? There is no hard and fast rule. You can sit on a chair, you can sit on a sofa. The sick patient can even lie down on the bed and can do it. You can do it on floor. Wherever you feel comfortable, whichever posture you find suitable, you can do it in that. But you have to do it. You have no excuse that I can't do it. Next comes the pranayama. pranayam is also very good part of yoga. Whenever we do yoga exercise, we have to do with the breathing. That means when we do the first part of yogic exercise, we have to breathe in. Just like I give you an example, breathe in, go up. Then hold, breathe out slowly, slowly, and then come down. So this is the rhythm. This will give you 10 times benefit. In this way, yoga and pranayama are going hand in hand, in harmony. So here you are doing yoga with pranayama. That is the ultimate thing. Then in the third step comes that you have to give some pressure and swing. That I will give you in demonstration, that young people can do it. The old and sick people can avoid it. Children can do it. And next is, whichever the asanas are requiring more strength, more energy, more speed, even in breathing, you need more speed and more force. That should not be done by the people who are having blood pressure or heart problem. They can do it very slowly, very calmly, without any force. Next, there are other asanas in which we have to bend forward. Whenever you have to bend forward, those who are having cervical back pain, they should not do bending forward. That will aggravate the problem. Then you will blame the yoga. You will say that I have done yoga, my problem has increased. So the people with back pain and cervical should not do any asana, any posture in which you have to do bend forward. Similarly, the people with problem of hernia and stomach pain, problem in the belly, they should not do the backward point. This is the theory of both of them. If the spine problem, people are doing backward bend, it is healthy. If the hernia people are doing the forward bend, it is healthy for them. Both are reverse, hernia and back pain. So these some rhythms, we have to follow it. Then in nutshell, we come to the final point, which is the most important. We have seen in practice all over that even the yoga therapist, yoga trainer, gym trainer, the coach, sports coach, they are falling sick. They are having so many problems. It doesn't spare anybody. Why? Though they are attached with the sports, they are attached with the yoga, still they are suffering. The basic point is that they have to do so many other things also. Only yoga will not help to remain healthy, to enjoy the life mentally, physically. You will not be healthy only by yoga. Yoga will unite. Yoga means togetherness, combination of body, mind and soul. It will definitely unite. But final result will come only when you do something addition. Whenever you make some vegetable or butter pulao or something, you have to, instead of the vegetable, addition to the vegetable, you have to add into that some masala, spices, ingredients to make it more tasty, more enjoyable. Similarly, to enjoy the life, in addition to yoga, you have to do something more also. Only yoga will not help. And mind it, any activity, there are so many activities, they help you remain healthy. For example, if you go to temple, pray to God, people go for good health. There are people who wear a mala or something for good health. There are people who will wear some ring and some stone for good health. There are people who will do some mantra jap or chanting for good health. So these are many techniques. There are many ways to remain healthy. But any single way will not lead you to good health. You have to do so many things together only then you get the ultimate best result. In that, the nutshell, I tell you that you have to help others. This is, nobody will tell you, it's not mentioned in any yoga group discussion and anywhere that you have to help others. This is a very big point. It is very good for children also. And others is a small word, but it has a very big meaning. What is others? And what is help? Help is a very big meaning. Help may be very small, a pinch of salt, or a simple smile may be a help. And others is also a very big domain. Normally, people think that the people, persons who are living in the house, within the family, within the house, within the flat, that are ours. And the people who are outside the house and the boundary, they are others. So, everybody, you have to help everybody. You have to help others, which are outside. Inside, you always help. You cooperate with the people in the house, but you don't cooperate with the people outside. In others comes your neighbors, your relatives, which are far away, maybe in the same town, maybe in another town, maybe in the foreign country. In others comes the beggar on the street. In other comes the people all over the world. This whole cosmos, whole world is one family. Not the family within the boundary. This big boundary is our family. So you have to help everybody. Then you will gain something. Next, in addition to help, you have to do some help also. Others I have explained. In the help, I told you that you have to give something. Whatever small thing you can afford, you can give. If you can't afford anything, you can talk nicely, you can give a smile, that is also enough. But when you do these two things in your lifestyle, introduce in your lifestyle, the third thing, which is very important, will flow automatically. Then you go to the top. That is the charity. When do these two things come in your life, the charity will come automatically. Charity means giving something. You give something to other person. So that is very nice. And when charity comes, the third stage, the fourth stage will also come automatically. Nobody can stop it. And that is the best. That is the blessings. We get the blessings. Sometimes we get the blessings, we feel it immediately. Sometimes we get the blessing, we get later on, we don't feel it. So we have to collect the blessings from this universe. God has created everything for us to help others and to create blessing for yourself. You have to love Mother Earth, nature, Prakriti. The nature, the Mother Earth has given us very good trees, fruits, vegetables. We enjoy them. Nature is giving us oxygen to breathe. Sun is giving us regular vitamin D and energy to ripe the fruit, ripe the grains. So in so many ways, the nature and Prakriti, Mother Earth is giving you so many things, but we never thank them. That is the first part. We never thank. Have we ever thanked the God Sun for giving the daylight, sunlight without any cost? We don't do it. We must thank it. We must thank all the tattva. Five tattva is there, five elements are there in the universe. We must thank all of them. So then we get the blessings. And that blessings will create a very good platform for the everlasting good health. Then the other part is come also very important, which nobody is touching, is respect your elders. respect your parents, respect your guru. This much we know, but we don't go beyond this. Even our children also don't go beyond that. We have to go beyond that. Today we are living because of our parents, because of our grandparents and grand-grandparents also. So our DNA is coming from the top. We have to thank the top, which is flowing. Water is flowing from the top. We have to thank the top all the time for present life. Then we get the blessings for our ancestors, which is also very much essential. So we have to start from the elders, from the home. And elders means not only at the home, I have told you others. From others also, you have to respect and take the blessings. So that will give you good health, lasting health. And you will enjoy minimum 100 years without any problem, or without any disease. And my motto is also like this, to live for minimum 100 years without any disease, without any pill. And I'm sure I will succeed and God will help me. Now, I think I have spoken enough and we come to the little yoga and exercise part, asana part. And before that, we can also do pranayama. There are different type of breathing exercises which help us to generate oxygen in the body. And these pranayama, various pranayama, help us in healing our chakras. All the 7 chakras are healed automatically by doing this pranayama on regular basis. So first we start with the Anulom Vilom pranayama, which is very good for children also, elders also, people who are having sleep disorder, mental tension, depression, anxiety, high blood pressure, and craziness, mood swing. Nowadays, mood swing is a very, very big problem. So that will also go away with this pranayama, Anulom Vilom pranayama. You have to put your hands like this. These two hands put here and breathe from the right side. Long breath you take up, chest up, shoulder up, breathe in, go up. And stop it with this nose. Breathe out slowly, 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 go down and put the chin here. Then again, put the hand here. Breathe in slowly, very slowly, slowly, gradually up. This pranayama has to be done as slowly as possible. This is the beauty of this pranayama. No pranayama is that slow as slow is this pranayama. In this, the theory is that if you have put talcum powder or wheat flour or whatever you keep here, and when you breathe out, it should not blow out. It should remain there. You have to breathe out so slowly that it should not blow out that talcum powder or something which you are putting here. That is the test of it. So very slow you have to do it. It will control your blood pressure very nicely. Hypertension, mood swing, sleep disorder, memory problem. So many things will be tackled automatically with this. Next, we come to the Bhamri Pranayama. In this, we have to close our, I have the earbuds, I won't be able to do it, but I give you a demonstration. In this Anulom Vilom Pranayama, first we have closed this and breath in. Next time, you have to take the other hand, you have to close this and breathe in from this side. So this is alternate breathing. The other name for this Anulom Vilom Pranayama is alternate breathing. One time from this side, one time from this side. This you have to give minimum 25 times. If you are not able to do 25 times, you can do 5 times, 10 times at a stretch. Have a rest, then relax. And whenever you do asana, between one asana and other asana, you should have a draft. And every asana you have to do as per your ability, as per your strength, not overdo, not underdo also, moderation mein, as per your body. The sick people, the BP and heart people have to take special care. Children can take little risk. They can do fast action, forceful action, but not the old and the sick. So Bhamri Pranayam, you have to close your ears like this. Your these three fingers will come here, here and here. Your middle finger, this forefinger will come here. And you have to take a long breath. When you take a long breath, you will make a sound, humming sound from the throat. Just like you have an ass blowing the mouth very loudly, like that. Like a horse. Whenever you do this, breathe in, go up. Close the ears. Close the eyes. Press in. All pressure here. Every fingertips will have the pressure. And then breathe in, chest up, go up and close this. This will help in your thyroid. This will help in your memory problem. This will help in your sinus and so many other problems also. Then we come to the Kapalbhati Pranayama. Kapalbhati Pranayama is the master pranayama for so many diseases, and especially nowadays we have the oxygen problem, we have the fat problem and asthma problem. This will heal it very nicely. This is in the present time. Apart from that, this pranayama also helps in any body pain. If you have pain in the neck, pain in the knees, pain in the cervical, pain in the back, this also will be healed. This is a miraculous pranayama. I will show you the technique, different techniques for different problems. Then comes for the hair. People are suffering, ladies and gents are suffering for the hair loss. So for hair strength, also this pranayama will help you a lot. So I will give you technique. First, the fundamental technique that you have to do, how to do it. In this, the basic is you have to breathe in and out with speed. Mind it, BP and heart trouble people will not do it. More back pain people will not do it or do it very, very slowly. So you have to breathe in and out with speed. Breathe out with fast speed. Whenever you breathe out with a jerk, your belly should go in. When your belly go in, it will go normally this much. But with the hand, with force, you have to again press it more. 1 inch more, it will go down. So this will help you in fat loss, in digestion, and in sugar also. So this way is the pranayama for sugar, fat loss, and chest, oxygen, asthma. It is modified for the hair loss. You do it with your mind up and down. At the same time, you move your hands. I am doing two things at a time. Moving the hands, the nails, this is the acupressure. Acupressure of nails like this, 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 and my belly is moving up and down and my breathing is moving with speed. Breathe out with speed. All oxygen will go out with high speed. And next comes the pain problem. If you have pain in your neck, pain in your pain in your knees, pain in your feet, pain in your neck, wherever you are, pain in your arm. Wherever you are pain, this is a thumb rule. Suppose you have pain in your knees. This is a very common problem. Put your hand on the feet. Very simple. And now you start the Kapalbhati Pranayama. Concentrate your mind on your knees. Concentrate your mind on your knees, that your energy is going from hand to your knees. knees will heal automatically. You will feel it within few days. Similarly, you have a back pain. You have slip disc. Put your hand here and start Kapalbhati. If you have pain in the neck, pain in the arm, put here Kapalbhati. So it has multiple actions. And this I have tested on so many people, so many times. It proved 100% correct and good. So this you can try, very simple technique. I think these three pranayams will help you quite a lot. And next I come to another one mudra for meditation and dhyana. There are two mudras. I can, either you can do this, Jnana mudra. These two tips join together, put the hand here and start very slow breathing. Concentrate on your breathing. Have your mind on your breath moving in and out, and this mudra. This will give you a lot of peace of mind, lot of concentration, good sleep. Next, other is this Lord Buddha mudra. Lord Buddha many times sits like this. So you can sit like this in your lap, the hands, and again do the same breathing slowly in the same fashion. And it will give you a lot of mental peace. So I hope I have covered a lot. No, one more mudra I will give you is the Sanjeevani mudra, Mrityu Sanjeevani mudra. If this will bring a person having even heart attack, it will bring him up, severe heart attack. The mudra is like this, that you have to put your hands like this, first finger like this, next two fingers like this with the thumb, and this also like this, 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 and start breathing. Slow breathing. It will heal. Next, because the patient is down, not able to do it, if you do it regularly, no heart trouble, no BP. For the patient who is suffering with angina or heart trouble, take up this small finger. Just rub it like this. Nails, upper area, the first tip, the top. Rub this area. The more you rub, more you press, before the doctor comes, he will feel healthy. He will feel better. Doctor will take 10-15 minutes to come at least. But start doing this immediately. His pulse will be better. His heart will be better. This you can do in both the hands and in the toes, in the feet also. So I have covered, I think, enough. I have taken enough of your time. I thank you all for giving me this time and listening to me. And I'm thankful to WWF India for organizing this to help all the people on this International Yoga Day. Thank you very much.
Live, a platform to sharing your thoughts.